Welcome back everyone to your sixth video in your database clustering series. This video we are going to be running some commands inside of this desktop and also setting up a couple other virtual machines so we can use them as nodes for our database cluster. So the very first thing we're going to want to do is right click and click open terminal. Now that this is open, we want to pin that to the launcher. So just click lock to launcher. Now when we X out of it, you can open it very easily just by clicking it right there. I guess that's not saving a whole lot of effort rather than just right-clicking and clicking new terminal, but it actually does save you one click, so that's conserved energy for other uses, so you're welcome. Now, when you open this for the first time, you can see it says, to run a command as administrator, user root, use sudo. So sudo is a way to run one command as the super user or the administrator, essentially. Before we start doing stuff, we want to make sure everything we have is up to date. So we are going to do that by saying sudo apt-get update. And then once that is done running, you can use a semicolon to give another command and say sudo apt-get upgrade. So click enter, type in your password. And this might take a couple minutes, so just be patient. Yes. And that just finished, which is great. There's one more thing I wanted to do before I clone this virtual machine. And that is, I want to set this up for SSH, which is something we are going to be doing later. The software that we're going to be using needs SSH access to all of the nodes in the cluster. And it will also need SSH access to itself, which we'll get into that soon, but for now, I just want to set up the SSH server. So to do that, we're just going to type sudo apt-get install openssh-server. Type in your password. Yes. And there we go. Now I would say that this machine is in the state to start cloning it into the other nodes. So what we're going to do is we can just X out of that. And we can shut down, open VirtualBox again, and before we clone this thing, there is one last thing we need to do, and that has to do with the way VirtualBox is set up. So our actual virtual machine is good, but there's one thing we need to do inside of VirtualBox, and that is setting up this thing to be on a particular type of network. So if you right-click it and click Settings, and then you go to Network, these are where the network settings for this virtual machine are set. This NAT is not going to work exactly for what we want. So what we're going to do is actually add another adapter and click Enable Network Adapter. Essentially what we're trying to do is make it so that once we have multiple nodes, we want them to be able to communicate with each other on the same network. To do that, you want to click this dropdown and click Host Only Adapter. And then we can select what network we want it to be on. And I think this VBox Net 0 is on by default. And then you can click OK. Now we are ready to clone. So right click and click clone. We can give it a new name. This one is going to be the one that we have cluster control on. And we want to make sure we click reinitialize the MAC address of all network cards. That will make sure the networking works correctly. Click continue. Click clone and this will begin processing and it'll just take a couple seconds. The next thing we're going to do is make one of the master nodes. So we can take that starter, clone it again, and this time we can call it master one, reinitialize, continue. Full clone, clone. Great, we got one more to do. So right click, clone, and this one is going to be master two. And the reason they're both master is because we are going to be using Galera, which is a master-master topology. So we're not going to have any slave nodes in this situation. Make sure you click reinitialize the MAC address and then click continue. So those all finished. What I'm going to do is I'm actually going to take these and drag them to the top. Awesome. So we have all of our virtual machines ready to go. The next thing that we need to do is set up SSH so they actually can communicate with one another through SSH. Yes, I know we did set up the SSH server, but there's a particular kind of SSH called passwordless SSH, and that deals with public and private keys that we're going to have to put on these virtual machines. So the next video is going to be teaching you guys how to do that. If you've enjoyed this series, I just ask that you please subscribe, click like, and that really just helps me know that you guys are appreciating my content. and it encourages me to make more content. So please do that, and I will see you all in the next video. Thanks, guys.